Kareem Rodney and Kizzy Badeau can help their boys aged 4 and 7 with a lot of things, from schoolwork to playing basketball. But when it comes to conversations about racism, they wish some of it took place in their classrooms.
I definitely think it's very important at this age. This is the age is when kids are really inquisitive, asking what, why, when.
Discussions about anti-black racism aren't usually in the curriculum for elementary schools. They're sometimes brought up as a possible topic within, say, social studies. But just how much the subject is talked about, if at all, is often up to the individual teacher.
So this is a headpiece, right? Just like what you were showing me your head.
For Curtis Dardane, who teaches a diverse body of students, talking about racism starts with kids sharing their own experiences.
In beginning that conversation on what anti-black racism means, what black excellence means, and how their voices, their lived experiences, and their family matter. And it matters just as much as everyone else's. And that hasn't been the narrative.
Nice.
Kizzy Badeau would like to see those types of conversations mandated in the curriculum for all students.
We also have to teach the non-black children of what that means and how they could potentially be perpetrating that or what a microaggression could be.
But BC teacher Monica Noakes says every teacher has to find their own approach. Hers is through teaching empathy, even sharing what's happened to her.
Some of them hadn't heard of, they've heard of racism, but having someone who they know have experienced it, and me as the teacher telling them my stories of experiencing racism in Canada was very moving for them.
A lesson in fairness, respect, and compassion, hopefully giving them a head start in confronting racism in society. Deanna Siwanag-Johnson, CBC News, Toronto.